Hello guys, I'm Dr. Neeraj and today's topic is Southern Hybridization and which is also called as Southern Blotting. So without any delay, let's move to the video. So as the bloating word is coming in the technique Southern Blotting, so first of all we should know that what is bloating. Bloating, it is generally you can say the method by which we transfer the DNA, RNA or protein molecule onto the membrane. The membrane may be either of nitrocellulose membrane or nylon membrane. So the transfer of this DNA RNA protein onto membrane, that is known as the bloating. Now what is Southern hybridization? The Southern hybridization or Southern blotting is a technique which is used for the detection of specific DNA sequence from DNA samples. Means when you have many DNAs and you have to select out or you have to detect one specific DNA sequence, in that case this technique, that is Southern hybridization, is used. Or you can say by this technique you can detect the specific DNA from that DNA sample. This Southern hybridization technique, it is named after its inventor, that is Edwin Southern. He invented this technique in 1975. Now let's discuss the complete procedure of the Southern hybridization. So for example, if you want to detect a specific DNA sequence from many DNA samples, like in case of humans, the DNA can be extracted from any tissue, but here we are taking the example of blood. So ultimately the first step of the Southern hybridization is the extraction, or you can say isolation, of DNA. So now as the DNA has been extracted, in the next step this DNA molecule, now it is fragmented into small DNA fragments. And this step is usually done by using the enzymes, that is restriction enzymes. These restriction enzymes, they cleave the larger DNA fragment into the small DNA fragment. In the next step, these small DNA fragments, these are separated on the basis of their size. And for this, we generally carried out the agarose gel electrophoresis. Electrophoresis is a technique which separates the molecule on the basis of their charge. And here we are using the agarose gel electrophoresis. So that technique, it separates the molecules on the basis of their charge and size. So the shorter fragment, they move further, while the larger fragment, they move slowly, so they remain behind. So due to this, these DNA fragments, they are separated according to their size. In the next step, these DNA fragments, these are allowed to denature. Why? Because we know these DNA strands, these are double-stranded. But in order to detect a specific DNA molecule, these double-stranded DNA fragments, they are converted into single-stranded DNA fragments. And for this, we carried out the alkaline denaturation. Means we place our this DNA fragment into the alkaline solution. So due to the pH, these double-stranded DNA, these two strands, they get separated out. And the double-stranded DNA molecule is converted into single-stranded DNA molecule. Now these single-stranded DNA fragments, these are transferred to the nylon membrane, which is the bloating. That's why also known as Southern blotting. So these single-stranded DNA molecule, now these are transferred to the nylon membrane. After transfer to the nylon membrane, in the next step, these DNA fragments, which is now single-stranded, they are allowed to hybridize, or these are now allowed to bind with the probes which are specific for the specific DNA fragments. What are probes? These are, you can say, these are also single-stranded DNA molecules or RNA molecules which are specific or which have the complementary sequence against the specific DNA fragments. Means they will only bind to the fragment to which they are complementary. And these probes are chosen in order to detect a specific DNA fragment from this nylon membrane. These probes, these are also labeled at their one end in order to detect their position. They can either be radio labeled or fluorescence labeled. And in the next step, it is a detection of these probes. Means once this probe has been hybridized with this DNA fragment, or you can say with this specific DNA fragments, now their position, it is detected. And for this, we generally use the autoradiography technique. If the probe were radio labeled, means these probes have radioactively labeled, and they emit some radiations which can now be detected by using the autoradiography technique. And once we detect their positions, so we can say that we can also detect that specific fragment which we want to isolate, because the specific probe will only hybridize to specific DNA fragment. So by this step or by this procedure, we can easily detect or we can easily isolate a specific DNA molecule from the DNA samples. Now, what are the applications of this technique? So the first technique, as you can clearly see, we can detect the DNA from given sample. The next is that its technique is used in the DNA fingerprinting. And as it is used in DNA fingerprinting, so it can also be used for the paternity testing, criminal identification, or you can say victim identification. And lastly, we can also use the Southern hybridization to isolate the desired gene of interest. Means from the sample, or you can from the many fragments of DNA, the gene of interest, the gene which we want to isolate, which it can be isolated or it can be identified by using a specific probe which have complementary sequence to the gene of interest. So once the probe has been designed, it will bind to the gene of interest, and now we can detect the probe and isolate our gene of interest. So these are the applications of Southern hybridization or Southern blotting. So that's all for today, guys. See you in the next video. Thank you very much.